It's 5,000 miles in between Sweden and Oklahoma, right smack dab in the middle of the US where I'm from, and after living here in Stockholm for half a year, I have a very long list of things that Swedes do that would probably shock a lot of Americans. But for this video, I'll start with 7. Hey, I'm Erick Payne, and I'm an American living in Sweden. I used to be a TV news reporter in the US until I moved to Stockholm in April, and now you're stuck with me here on YouTube. Number one on my list is the shoehorns. Let's just do this first one like a band-aid and just rip it off. We'll get the most controversial thing I'll ever say out of the way. Everyone here in Sweden has at least one or several of these in their homes here, and if you don't know what they do, they basically help you put on your shoes.
Look, I've been around the world, okay? Whatever it is, I'll understand. There is nothing about this I understand.
I think these are overrated unless you're older or physically can't bend down easily to put on your shoes, so you will never see me use one of these, and that's all I have to say about it.
Into exile, I must go.
Number two, when you go to a restaurant in Stockholm for either lunch or dinner, your portion size is going to be the same, and despite that portion difference, your lunch is still going to be cheaper. And it's great, you're basically getting free food. But that's different from a lot of places in America where when you go and ask for the lunch portion, it's going to be cheaper, but it's also going to be a lot smaller than your dinner portion. Number three on my list, when you go to a grocery store or some other stores in Sweden, the cashier is usually sitting down. And if you're a Swede, you're thinking, that's just common sense, right? No.
We don't have that in America.
For some reason, it's frowned upon for cashiers to sit and work at a lot of stores in the US, and some people get really upset when they see cashiers sitting and working. But don't take my word for it, here's some proof. I went to Quora, and random Americans are saying things like, "This is not Europe. To sit is to be seen as lazy. Only Aldi cashiers sit in the USA. I am a cashier in the United States for 24 plus years, and in my opinion, sitting on your butt while ringing up people purchases don't look professional. I mean, that's why I don't like Aldi's. Plus, Aldi's is a generic store, and in my opinion, their food is not all that good. And also my personal favorite, because other countries are lazy and not in the shape, health-wise, as we are." And that one's especially stupid because according to the Bloomberg Global Health Index, the US is the 35th healthiest country in the world. That's behind Sweden and also pretty much every single European country. Sweden is ranked 6th, by the way. All right, number 4 on the list. There are a ton of parents walking around with strollers here in Sweden.
We need to talk about the BABEE.
A big part of that is because everything is super walkable here in Sweden, but it's also a really big part of the culture that both of the parents are generally really involved in kids' lives. You can also see that with the really generous paid maternity and paternity leave that's mandated by the government, and all the companies are pretty accepting of it as well. Let's talk about the weather here in Sweden. There's a really popular phrase that's, "There is no bad weather, only bad clothes." And that kind of hints at the incredibly boring weather here in Sweden. I mean, you have your spring, you have summer, fall and winter here is not the best generally, but I am here to report that there is definitely a such thing as bad weather, and you can go to this entire section of the US to find it. In a lot of the Midwestern US, you're glued to your TV when storms hit. There's nonstop weather coverage, weather-related TV specials, and storm chasers. The meteorologist at the Tulsa station that I worked at was basically a household legend, and I'm not exaggerating.
He is the king of the Tulsa weather scene. We call him Travis Meyer.
There's Travis Meyer memes, like this one, and then there was one that was made into stickers, and then there was this one, and it doesn't even stop there because one business sold these Travis Meyer candles. So people take their storm season weather very seriously in parts of the US like in Oklahoma, and since I moved to Sweden, I have not had to look at my weather radar once.
Well, what are you waiting for?
I don't know, something amazing, I guess.
Number 6 on my list of things in Sweden that would be a culture shock to Americans, Swedes love queues. When you're at a lot of stores here in Stockholm, odds are there's probably a queue unless it's a grocery store or another small shop. So even if there's nobody else in the store, you should probably be prepared to pull a number from a machine and wait until an employee rings up your number. And finally, if you live closer to the equator and have a somewhat normal amount of sunlight at nighttime across the year, then you're gonna be pretty shocked when you're here in Sweden. Winter is pretty rough. December 21st is the shortest day here. It has only 6 hours of sunlight, but when you get to the summer here in Sweden, it's great. It's almost never dark. On June 21st, the longest day, there's more than 18 hours of sunlight.
No, it's nice. I think this might be it.
Wow, hey, look, you guys, the sun's rising.
If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like, comment, and subscribing to my channel. It really helps me out. And if you missed my last video, it's about Yule Must or Swedish Christmas soda and how companies like Pepsi and Coca-Cola have failed to successfully copy its Nordic success over in the US. You can watch that by clicking here. Thanks for watching.